In this video, we'll talk about all of the free methods of securing your website. This includes encryption via SSL, blocking bots and spam, stopping brute force attacks, and much more. After this, your website should be like a fortress. For this tutorial, I'm going to use a fresh new website hosted on SiteGround that has absolutely zero security features activated. As you can see here, it even says not secure next to my domain name. So we can work through everything together. We're going to be adding multiple layers of security. Let's start with the basics. Hop onto your WordPress dashboard. You can reach that by typing in /wp-admin after your website name and logging into your WordPress dashboard. Hover over plugins, then select add new. Search for iThemes security and click install now, then activate. Now, you'll have a button that's appeared on your dashboard called security. Click on it and click secure site. Then type in your email address and click activate network brute force protection. So right away, this makes your website way more secure. But this is like a very broad security measure, more of a good practice than a true security setup. What I mean by this is, well, basically there's plenty more securing left to do in, so let's get right to it. In my opinion, the best security is prevention. So let's make sure some attacks never even happen in the first place. When inside your WordPress dashboard, click on the security button once more. Now in the top right corner, click on the small all button, and this will give you more options. Find the hide backend option and click on configure settings. Then click the Enable Hide Backend Feature checkbox. Here, you'll change the default wp-login text to something unique. For example, I'll use Emit-Go. And then click Save Settings. If I would open an incognito tab right now and would try to log into my website using the wp-admin, it no longer works. I need to use Emit-Go. So, on the surface, this might seem like a small deal. But this is actually the opposite of a small deal. It is, in fact, a big deal. A very big deal. Because it automatically prevents a huge portion of automated attacks and amateur hackers. Because now most people can't even easily tell that you're using WordPress. Basically, with this one change, you prevented a lot of attacks because people won't even try. But keep watching, it gets better. Let's stop another very common hacking attempt called the brute force attack. When hackers use a software to guess millions of different login and password combinations per second. First, let's click the security button once again. Then at the top right, select all once more and find the local brute force protection option. Click on configure settings, then you'll need to click on global settings and scroll all the way down. Change the blacklist threshold to 2, then scroll down again and click add my current IP to the whitelist. Don't forget to click Save Settings. What this does is it makes you immune to the changes we're making here. Because to stop the brute force attacks, what we're going to do is we're going to put on a limit on how many times people can attempt to log in before they get stopped permanently. However, sometimes you simply forget the password to your own website and then you try one of the 5 billion variations of that one password that you have. And I don't want for you to get banned from your own website. That's why we're whitelisting the IP address so you can try as many times as you want, but other people can't. I also highly recommend going back into the local brute force protection and setting the login attempts from 10 to 5, just to be on the safe side. Next in line are website backups. Are website backups mandatory? Absolutely not. But it's like having one extra beer at the back of the fridge. When you really need it, you'll be thankful it's there. For this tutorial, I'm using SiteGround as my web hosting provider. And it actually has all of the backup features built into the hosting plans. It backs my website up every single day and I can do a manual backup whenever I want. If you want to use SiteGround or other great web hosting providers that I recommend, I'll leave discount links in the description. These are the biggest discounts you can get online if you want to get started with these hosting providers.
But I want to keep this tutorial free, and I know that not everyone is using a web hosting provider that has built-in a backup functionality. So I'm going to show you how to do backups for free. It's a bit janky and not as convenient, but having at least one backup per week or per month definitely won't hurt.
To get backups for free, we'll use a plugin called Updraft. So navigate to plugins and choose add new. In the search bar, type in Updraft and click install. Once it's finished installing, just click on activate and you'll be ready to go. you should be taken to this screen. Just need to click on press here to start. And then let's actually go into the settings and do some configurations. For the file backup schedules, I like to set it to weekly. So you'll get one automatic backup every single week.
For the backup storage itself, I like to use Google Drive. Why Google Drive, you might ask? Well, because it's cloud storage. The biggest problem with storing backups on your computer or hard drive is, well, if it shits the bed, you're kinda out of luck. But if it's cloud storage, you'll have it available from any device, anywhere you like.
Once you click Save Changes, you'll need to authorize Updraft to access your Google Drive so you can store files on there. You can do so by clicking this link right here, but think twice before using your main Gmail account. No matter how trustworthy or reputable a provider is, I always use a throwaway Google account if I give someone access to it. That's just good practice. Then you just need to click Complete Setup. And after a couple of minutes, you'll see Updraft send backups to your Google Drive account, and you can restore from them whenever you wish.
Okay, so we did all of these crazy security optimizations like full-on hacker mode, but if I would go to my website right now, it has like this huge, not secure tag next to my website name. What the hell is up with that? Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's called the SSL, and that means that my website doesn't have a valid SSL certificate installed and activated.
SSL, or Secure Socket Layer, basically creates a tunnel between the server and the user using various encryption methods. So people that are trying to phish for passwords or other information get absolutely nothing. Again, I'll use SiteGround here as an example for a secure provider, because if I would go to my site tools and click on security, then SSL manager, all I would need to do is choose let's encrypt and click on the get button. That's it, my website would turn from not secure to a green lock instantly.
Okay, so I completely understand that not everyone is using the exact same web hosting providers. But in fact, there is a way you can get a free SSL certificate on any web hosting provider. You can find a tutorial on how to do that right here. But if you're thinking about switching web hosting providers, I'll leave the ones that I personally recommend in the description down below, together with a discount. But it doesn't matter which web hosting provider you're using, if you followed this tutorial, you'll have much better than average WordPress security installed. But keep in mind that most hacks aren't even hacks, it's social engineering. Even Twitter was recently hacked by an employee mishandling information. So always be smart, don't click any stupid links, use strong passwords and all that jazz. For now, I hope you enjoyed this video. As I mentioned before, you can find discounts for my favorite web hosting providers in the description down below, and I'll see you in the next video.